Thank you for inviting me for this opportunity. I am a completely out of box compared to these three very prominent speakers and with a career. But I think I'd like to share with you some of the aspects. I think of the city and future, and also in this outline, we supposed to sort of project maybe 20 years from now. But to do that, maybe perhaps we might look back what happened 20 years earlier. And that's a time when Cold War ended. And the early 1990s, I think Japan went bubble burst. And all of a sudden, World Wide Web came into the sort of marketplace in 1991. At the same time, Cold War ended. That means Soviet Union disappeared. And that is sort of beginning of globalization. And now eBay and Yahoo and Amazon all came in 1993 or 94. So that was the time. But technology always advanced very fast, whatever. Technologist is always working on their own technology. Consequence, who cares? Humans are not so much adaptive to such a rapid change. So see what happened in the recent years. Now the first slide? First one. This is the third or no? Is this the first one? All right, now you begin to see everybody just doing this thing. And may not be listening to me, but I think that's the way we do. So every 30 minutes or 1 hour, you have to check your text message or this thing, and that's really technology change your behavior. And this happens, so even in this metro, on this train in Japan, just nobody speaks and everybody very quiet. And so that's what happens. And in fact, if you think about when this iPad came or iPhone came, that's only 7 years ago. And that really changed your behavior, touching thing. And the iPad came only 3 years ago. That changed a lot of behavior for every one of you. And that's also changing the business model and the way you think. And next slide. I had to do it. Oh, okay. So now I think everybody's connected, and this is what's happening in Japan. Nobody speaks, and nobody's just looking at each other, and nobody sees any expression, no dialogue, and that's it. So that at the end, I think you're sort of evolving to a long time, but all of a sudden you're connected into your gadget, and you are not talking to anyone, but you have to respond to that person who was connecting through net. But you never saw them. No dialogue, no facial expression, which has been very unique to humans. And we speak each other, and with some movement of your body and facial expression, you like me, or I like you, this or that, but somehow you're connected. And because of this connectivity, you may send many emails by CC, and many CCs, when you receive it, somehow you are urged to respond, otherwise you become left alone, right? So that means your depths of your thinking in response has become very shallow and very short, but you're forced to respond. Otherwise, those who send you email or something, text mail, why not responding to me? And even this many countries, the young girls or just boys and youngsters are much in trouble. They are very bullied in this thing and just even commit suicide in a few days ago. That's the way we have been working now. So I think technology always advances. Don't worry, just they do, regardless of you like it or not. So that's what it is. So singularity will coming very soon. According to some of the literature, I think singularity, what's happening, come down to singularity. This is the year of years. So from left, life emerges on the planet. That's eukaryotic cell. This is not human yet. Cambrian explosion to primate and super family, hominid and family, and then human ancestor, walk and spoken language, Homo sapiens, about maybe 100,000 years ago. And then this logarithmic space, Homo sapiens came, 100,000 years of art, early cities, some cluster of people, and then agriculture, 10,000 years ago. All of a sudden, we don't need to worry about something to eat tomorrow, but in a month ahead, and then agriculture came, and all of a sudden, a few thousand years later, like civilization emerged somewhere. That is the source of origin of city we are talking about. We heard about London and New York, and also we are in Tokyo. This is a sort of vision by Minoru Mori-san, which really started in materialize 10 years ago, and that's of course Embrace Museum, because this is a thing, I think, give you something to think about. And this is city states emerge. all of a sudden, maybe last 100 to 200 years, city-states in medieval time, like Venice and Florence, but now become a big nation. And all of a sudden, nation controls cities, and city become bigger since industry revolution of maybe last 200 years. And all of a sudden, like steel, so like London, if you go to like some medieval city or Toledo or somewhere in Europe, and you feel very comfortable, right? But if you go to big city, we are talking about big city because you're big city boys and girls, so and that you live your life. So you think this is given, but not really. Many cities of maybe 100 to 200,000 people, which some cities in Aix-Provence is very nice, right? But in industry revolution, almost 200 years, that really begin to change our behavior very radically. That is sort of and expanding our way of communication and transportation, and railway came and steel, and then all of a sudden steel came into the marketplace, and then structure become bigger and bigger. And 100 years ago, automobile, T-Ford, 1908, even 1905, Einstein discovered E=MC2. 40 years later, A-bomb. Now, 2 years ago, there's a Fukushima. What are you going to do? And Wright Brothers, first flight, 10 seconds, that's 1904. Now you're flying in, just non-stop from London, New York, right? That's the way it is in technology, only 100 years. Now, can we adapt? So you arrived today from London, right? That's great. That's amazing. It doesn't happen 20, 30 years ago. So all of a sudden, computer came, now iPhone. Now then what happened? Baby. iPad came into the marketplace only 3 years ago, so baby are born with iPad. And parents show the photograph and moving thing, and they start touching it, and if you give this girl a book, she just touches thing, not just paging thing. So that's what they do. So they communicate each other, and that's the way it is, and it's going to be much faster and faster. And because of technology, it never stops. So that become a singularity. But somehow when you see that, somehow you that remind you of something, of your old time, which many city family may not see. So I think maybe you, I think allow you to have a mobilization and maybe city become more independent eventually, go back to 500 years earlier, because many cities become quite independent. You elect your mayor, and I think you want more mobility where your talent may be, and this is art. So art become a very important element of life again, and I think always has been a very important element, because artists, poets, performing arts, they are sending some message to us. Look at this thing. Everybody knows, I don't know what it is, but that's give you something, some message for each of you. So that's where museum is, great. But performing art, artists, poets, in Japanese, hatarakedo, hatarakedo, jitto te o miru.
No matter how much a day you work, I still will have to look at the hand.
So that is city, but we are talking about Tokyo, London, New York, big, big cities. And if you are born in the city, and the wealthy part, and also like poor part, I'm not so sure what kind of life you like to be. And if you have a family, you like to get a little bit outside because you like to have your home, which means home, kate, home, ye, and also te, that means garden, like to have this environment and touching some environment, and the house and garden. That is a unit of home, but I think it's not going to be with high-rise building. So somehow we share that kind of sentiment. We know our generation knows that kind of past history of art and urban and progress in science and technology, but all of a sudden these children do not know what kind of life they are heading for, because Joe Ito mentioned this thing, technology always advances. They are born with touch panel, not born digital. So I think what kind of life they are expecting to spend. And in the city, more than half of people in the world, expanding world, live in the city. And these cities need some space, identity, and look at what part of your brain you're working on this thing, and that is towards the singularity. It's coming sometime. According to Kurzweil, I think there'll be enough technological advance so that any MOOC and all the thing, digital knowledge you have to learn through college will be in the small tip with advancement of IT technology, nanotechnology, and life sciences, and make a small tip so you put in your brain, everybody has all the digital knowledge. That is coming, according to him, perhaps in 20 years from now, and see what happens. Thank you.